Hiya.
Hi. Have you got a minute?
Yeah, sure, come in.
No, I'm sure it's fine.
Okay.
Listen, I think I might owe you an apology.
What for?
For making a hash of playing Cupid.
What do you mean?
Keith.
What? Oh, I get it. You put him up to asking me out.
Now, well, I might have just mentioned that I thought you fancied him, you know.
You did what?
Well, I was only trying to help, you know, get things moving.
But I don't fancy Keith.
Yeah, well, I know that now. You're really mad with me.
Of course I am. You can't just go round telling people I fancy them.
Sorry. I knew you fancied somebody. I just assumed it was him, you know.
Well, you assumed wrong, didn't you?
Is it someone at college? Go on. You can tell your Uncle Sinbad.
You don't give up, do you?
I know. Hey, that's the big secret, isn't it? Not a lad at all, is it? It's a lecturer. An older fella. Go on, I'm right, aren't I?
Almost.
So it is a lecturer, then?
No.
Well?
You're right about it not being a lad, though. And it's not some older fella, either.
So who is it, then?
I don't know. I think... it's another girl. So now you know.
Hi, hello, Beth.
Hi.
Look, I'll just get those things from upstairs and I'll see Margaret later.
All right, see ya.
Is Margaret not in there?
No, Christmas shopping.
Oh, well, call back later then. I just wanted to practice on the piano for the carol concert.
She might be busy. I'm cooking a chili for us.
Who's the us?
Me and Marg.
So, you two are an item then?
Hopefully. Look, I want to tidy the place up, so...
So you mean leave? You are a joke, do you know that? You were chasing me the other day.
Well, there was nothing down for me, was there?
What, and there is with Margaret?
Maybe. I like her. I won't deny that.
Well, she'll see straight through you.
Hiya.
Hi.
Is your mum in?
No, she's gone to Rachel's school carol concert.
Look, I'm sorry for poking me nose and causing a ruck with Keith. Have you talked to your mum about, you know, the other thing?
Do you really think that I could tell her I'm attracted to another girl?
You told me. I'm sure she'd understand.
She's got enough on her plate without worrying about me and boys, let alone a girl. Anyway, I don't think anyone would understand.
Well, I do. Well, I mean, mate. Anyway, you could be mistaken, you know. It might be just a crush you've got on whoever she is.
Do you think?
Yeah. I mean, when did it happen? When you went to university?
Yeah, I suppose. It's about that time.
So you've heard this sort of stuff goes on at universities. Well, you know, them lecturers, I know some of them are, well, you know...
Lesbians.
Well, I wouldn't have called them that. Anyway, like I said, it's probably just a crush. I've heard it happens, you know. Mind you, it's never happened to me. Nearest I got to that sort of thing was want my hair cut like Kevin Keegan. Look... I know I'm naff at this sort of thing, but maybe if you spoke to someone your own age, I mean, Margaret, she's your mate, isn't she?
No, I don't think so.
See, if you watch all this Oprah Winfrey stuff, I mean, you're nothing like the women she has on there.
But I don't know what it is. I've just got these feelings, these really strong feelings, and then it makes me feel like I want to be near her. I even think about her when I'm at university.
See? I told you there's nothing to worry about, it's just a crush. Defo, and it'll go away. Trust me. I'm a doctor.
Hiya, come in.
Hi. I just wanted to go over the Christmas carols on the piano, last minute practice.
Yeah, fine. Hey, guess what? Keith's just cooked us a meal, and it wasn't pizza. Can you believe it?
Excuse me, the bog calls.
Looks nice and cosy in here.
Yeah, I think it's another one of his attempts to win me over.
And is it working?
We're just going to
friends.
Well, you might be very careful how close you get to your friends.
How do you mean?
Well, the other week he was over asking me to go out with him. I knocked him back and, well, looks like it's your turn now.
You're kidding?
I wish I was, but he did ask me out.
Is this right? You got knocked back by Beth, so now you're trying it on with me.
It's not like that.
Tell me what it is like, then. You're making a fool out of me.
Look, I'm going out. I'm sorry, Marg. Cheers, mate.
Look, I hope you didn't think I was stirring things. I just thought you should know, that's all.
You can't trust anyone these days, not even your neighbours.
It's terrible, isn't it?
Yes, I feel very let down. I mean, someone must know who it was. Right, well, I'll let you get on. See you later.
See ya.
Bye.
Thank God you rescued me. I feel like it's written all over my face whenever he mentions that filter.
So he hasn't worked out his mic who sold it then?
No, I wouldn't like to be in Mike's shoes if he does. Anyway, why are you up so early? I thought you were on Christmas holidays.
Oh, I couldn't sleep. Any more hassle from Keith?
No. He's keeping a low profile since his failed seduction.
Well, I'm not surprised.
Where are you going?
To the shops to get some bread.
So am I.
Oh, well, great minds think alike.